Modra!
Gives it his best. Modra!
That is the mark of the year.
Kicks for the kickoff line out.
Modra!
Tony McGuinness brings it back. Modra at the back.
Square Modra. Modra take a run at it. He does and takes a beauty.
Would you please welcome our final inductee, Tony Modra.
Photo just there, gents. Tony, how are you, mate? Come over. You've had to wait all night. You've seen nine boys come through. Mate, congratulations. I think everyone watches those highlights and we can all remember them happening. It's an astounding highlight package and that's probably not even a quarter of what was there. But there was one or two that aren't there, Mods, what I want to talk about right now. Of course, Bill said too, you never got reported for tormenting your defenders, but when you're sitting on their heads, it's hard to get reported most of the time, isn't it? So it's not going to happen. But there was a bloke called Mick Martin. Now, let's have a look at this vision here, and we'll have a chat through this, Mods. This is 1997. Yeah. Okay, nice little mark here. Play on. What's happened?
Oh. Bit embarrassing, but yeah, I actually thought I'd play on that one because I wasn't too far out of the goal square, and unfortunately I missed it, and after that I tried to convince the goal umpire that it went over the line before it blew back and hit the post. But, you know, an umpire's alike, they don't change their minds too often.
Absolutely. Now, Mick actually enjoyed that moment, didn't he? Because he gave you a hard time after that for a while.
He did. He gave me a bit of grief after missing that one, so I was pretty forward-looking to see if I can get another one on him.
You had the last laugh, and it didn't take long. This happened just moments later.
Back to lip pack. So the doctor from 50 metres out. Modra's a high. Will he go back and have a shot this time?
Not bad for player down on confidence.
Sensational mark. And Modra from point blank range.
He's kicked it.
Didn't miss from there.
Nah,
so you had the last laugh, a few minutes later in that second quarter, you sit on his head and take a card.
Yeah, well, after I missed that first goal, he basically was giving me a bit of grief, as Mickey sometimes talks. He's pretty intelligent, actually, but the way he talks, he said, oh, you can't even kick a goal from 5 metres out. So I was pretty keen to get back on top of him, and old Mickey, you can't push him out of the way or get around him too much, so I had to go over the top of him for the next one. So, yeah, took a decent grab, went back and marked it, and I basically said to him straight afterwards, I said, I think I owe you a beer for that one, Mick, and he goes, oh, what do you mean? And I said, well, I think I just want a car on your head.
So that was 97, so I think there was a car in 93, a car in 97, and you sat on someone else's head in 2000 and you didn't even get a car then. I think you just got cash or something.
I just got cash for that one at Freo, yeah.
Mod's life on the farm now. I think everyone's intrigued because you don't stick your head out there all the time. You don't look for media coverage or anything like that. You just go quietly about your life. So I think people would love to know, what are you doing on the farm now?
Well, I live down at Victor Harbour, as everyone probably knows, and I'm a primary producer down there, and I also had a bit of livestock carting on the side too. So, I enjoy myself down there. It's a great community to live in, and, I love bringing up my kids there.
No one's hassling you there like they were in 93 when you used to go over to West Lakes and just try and get a sandwich or something. You'd be asked for about 1,000 autographs on the way over?
No, gone at those stages, so.
Well, Mod's a magnificent career, magnificent highlights too. I'm sure there's some people you'd love to thank.
Rightio. Okay. Well, first of all, I'd just like to thank the SANFL for selecting me. It's an honour and a privilege to be part of this tonight. And also, congratulations to all the other inductees. Well, I got the phone call in the truck. down home, and it just, I don't know, I was pretty much speechless, and it just brought me memories of things that used to happen in my career, and it's strange, there are a couple of memories there that I probably can't bring out tonight, but I might save that for my book later on, maybe, if I ever bring one out. But first of all, I'd really like to thank Mum and Dad for basically letting me enjoy my sport when I was a young fella. I was the youngest of five. So I've got my sisters here with me tonight. My brothers unfortunately couldn't make it, but I'll bring them up a bit later. Yeah, so they brought me up in the lovely community of Loxton, which are a very strong sporting community, and basically up there they let me achieve whatever I wanted to do, and I was into sports right from the word go. I played a bit of soccer up there, golf, football, cricket, athletics, everything. So I was pretty lucky, and I think that was pretty much a stepping stone to my career. I then had the privilege to come down to West Adelaide and try out. I got picked up by Doug Thomas. I came down, had a go at Westies, but didn't quite work out and ended up going home. But then, thanks to Doug, he gave me the faith and brought me back down again, which was pretty much the start of my career. So I've really got to thank one bloke here who I don't reckon I'll be up here tonight, and that's the bloke by the name of Doug Thomas. Sorry, I got something in my throat. Thanks, Doug. Also to the West Adelaide Football Club for giving me the opportunity to play there. I had some great memories there, and I got to meet a lot of special Westies families too. Like they really took me on board and treated me as their own. They're also here tonight, and some great names at Westies like the Pannenbergs and the Costellos. From then on there, I ended up getting picked up by Adelaide. I started off a bit slow, as Bill mentioned, but then I think 93 I ended up getting a bit of a kick and a catch there, and it started pretty much from there. Also at the time I met my lovely wife called Erica, who's with me here tonight. Hi, Erica. I really like to thank Erica, because we went through some good times and went through some hard times as well, but she stuck with me all the way through, and we now have a couple of kids, and we're really looking forward to the future there. So thanks, Erica. Anyway, going back to the Adelaide Football Club, I was pretty much lucky again, because I had a great guy in Doug Thomas starting my career. I also had another guy there who had a bit of faith in me too and put me under his wing in the name of Bill Sanders. So he was the one that things pretty much were pretty solid for me and wasn't expecting all the limelight and everything else, he treated me through it, and actually in the early days he was also my manager, so thanks for that, Bill Sanders. I then went on, and I also had some great coaches who were here tonight too. It's just an honour to see them out here as well. Guys like Cornsey, who was a great coach of mine, Russell Ebel as well, state football level, and also Knuckles Curley back at the Westies days too. So it's a great honour and a privilege being coached by those people. In 97-98, it was right, I didn't get an opportunity to play in a grand final, but they were good memories, even though I didn't get to play in them. But then I saw the Gowans boys here tonight, and it reminded me of when I actually got the opportunity to play with my brothers back up in Renmark. Just like the Gowan boys, they won a premiership too. Well, I sort of know what they feel like, whereas I got the opportunity to play with my brothers up at Renmark and win a premiership as well. So there's probably, to me, that was one of the biggest memories for me too. Unfortunately, they couldn't be here tonight, but I've got some very, very special memories up there in the grand finals. We drew the first week, had to come back the next week and play again, and we ended up winning by 10 goals, so that was pretty handy. But I don't know, I think with my brothers, I was sort of the young one of the family, and these were two older brothers that, you know, tended to look after me a fair bit, and especially one of them called me brother Rick. He was a pretty solid bloke, probably twice the size as me. Some people might know a few stories about him, but I remember one story one day where we were out there playing all together, and I was getting roughed up a bit by a few guys, and a bit of a scuffle broke out, And I went toe-to-toe with the guy, and unfortunately he got the better of me, and I got my tooth knocked out and whatever else. The scuffle went on a bit more. I'm around looking for my tooth or whatever. And then next thing, I heard a big oar from the crowd. And brothers, as they are, looking after you. I looked up, and then there's my brother, Rick. He's sitting there looking at me, walking up, goes, "Don't worry, bro, I fixed him up for you." Problem with that was, I went up to Rick and I said, "Oh, thanks very much for that, bro, but unfortunately, you got the wrong bloke." But anyway, so yeah, I had some great times with my brothers too, so I really wish they were here tonight, but they couldn't make it. So we'll go on, we'll move on. I'm getting a bit teary-eyed, must be something's in my eye, I'm sure of it. I said if I was going to get upset, I'd sit there and look at for Grinder and Jars, because they used to make me laugh when I was playing. So anyway, we're going all right here. So anyway, after that, I pretty much got a second go at Frio. They gave me the second chance, which I'm very grateful for, so I'd really love to thank them. And obviously, when I went over there weren't too many highlights. We didn't win too many games, but I got some good waves while I was over there, so that was one good thing. And stayed over there for about 5 years with my wife as well, and we met some really great families over there too. And we did a fair bit of surfing. Speaking of surfing, I've got some more friends here from the Gold Coast in the Cronins. So if anyone at the footy club wants to complain about me going surfing instead of training, you can blame that guy over there. after that, after Frio, we were there for 5 years. We wanted to travel around Australia for 2 or 3 years, pretty much. Had enough of football by then. We came back to Encounter Bay, where we still reside now, and I met a guy called Todd Butler. He was a local Sacker country cricketer as well, and he was sort of leasing my property at the time, and he decided to ask me if I wanted to come out and have a game of cricket down the local club, and I thought, yeah, why not, might as well. To get back into a bit of sport again, because 3 years off footy, you tend to get a bit wider and fatter and everything else, so I thought, yeah, no, I'll give that a go. And one thing led to another with cricket. As then it reminded me of the younger days, as soon as the cricket season finished, you're back into the footy season, so that all came about there, and I ended up playing under Todd Butler at the Encounter Bay Football Club and won a premiership at Keith too. So I'd really like to thank Butts tonight for just basically bringing me back to grassroots football. So thanks, Butts. Pretty much done here. I think also I'd really like to mention my other family and friends. I've got Erica's grandma here tonight, Alma. She loves her footy. She's 91 years old, and she was also the main reason, I think, too, that I got involved with Erica, because Erica didn't really know too much about football, and I think she asked Alma, because Alma loves her football, and sort of went out and asked Alma about me, and she gave her the go-ahead, so thanks, Alma. To all my supporters out there, I really like to thank you all, because you're the ones that, I don't know, you just supported me through and through wherever I was, and you're the reason why I guess I won some of these cars as well, because you didn't win cars unless people voted for you. So I really like to thank all the supporters as well. Well, I've nearly done that. Now that my sporting career is pretty much over, as my daughter said when I took her to school the other day, I had another young kid come up to me and ask me if my name was Tony Modra. My daughter basically said straight back to him, goes, "He's not Tony Modra anymore, he's my daddy." So that put an end to that. So even though I'm finished up and everything else, my best moments are now still to come. So I'm really looking forward, with my wife Erica, watching my kids grow up and achieve whatever that may be, as long as they enjoy it, like mum and dad did with me. So thank you very much.